further ado, because I'm right on time, we're going to invite our first speaker up, Elena Zhang from Natural Sciences. And she's going to talk to you about the impact of pediatric trauma brain injury on the hippocampal adult neurogenesis and cognitive function. All right, Elena, thank you.
Good morning. Since I only have 6 minutes, 45 seconds, I'm going to make it short and sweet. So trauma can induce blood vessel damage and cell death. Also can induce secondary injury. Secondary injury such as ischemia, edema, inflammation. Patients will experience neurological behavioral compromise and cognitive, even hormonal dysfunction later on. There's not much we can do about the primary injuries. However, the secondary injury provides a time window for treatment. I'm using animal models to explore potential treatments for pediatric brain injuries. When the animals are around 7 to 10 days old, that's equivalent to 1 to 4 year old human patients. I divide them into 3 groups. Naive means no intervention, healthy control. Sham means they went through everything without trauma. The TBI group means they got traumatic brain injury. 1 month after injury, I inject BRDU, a chemical that can label the neural stem cells. I do the behavioral tests at 2 to 3 months post-injury that equivalent to 12 to 18 years old children. First, I want to know whether pediatric traumatic brain injury can induce long-lasting cognitive deficits. I use spontaneous alternation in teammates. This test uses animals' natural instinct to explore new environment. For example, we go to a new place. First thing we're going to do is explore. Where is the restaurant? Where is the hotel? And if there's nothing going on there, we go to the other area. The same thing with animal. I put a healthy control into the teammates. They are going to turn left or right. But when they found, hey, there's nothing there, the next time they are going to turn to the next direction. But the animals in the TBI group, first time they turn left, second time left again, even if there's nothing going on there because they have learning and memory deficits. I used another test called novel object recognition. These tests use the animal's instinct, preference for novelty. I give the animal 2 identical toys. They can play with them for 5 minutes. And then I replace one of the old toy with a new one. The healthy controls always go to the new toy and spend a lot of time playing with a new toy, just like us. However, animals in the TBI group, they spend almost equal amount of time playing with the old and new toys. That may indicate, hey, they forgot they ever played with the old toy before because they have learning and memory deficits. Neural stem cells, they play important roles in learning, memory, and even mood regulation. And we do have neural stem cells located at the hippocampus. The neural stem cells can differentiate and become new neurons even when we're adults. However, injury can damage or even deplete your neural stem cells. So later on, you have lack new neurons, or those neurons can go to the wrong place. It means they are not going to be functional. My group investigates the neural stem cell function after pediatric TBI. Look at those little green dots. Those are neural stem cells. Only those dots located within those 2 stripes are functional neurons. Compared with the healthy control group, PDI group, has much less number of new neurons. And also, if you notice, there are many green cells in this area. Apologize for the. In the center area, that's the HeLAs. And those green cells, we don't know what they are yet. Our group did investigation, demonstrate some of the cells are neurons, but they are located at the wrong places. It means they may not be functional. And many of the cells, they are not even glia cells, they are not even neurons, they are glia cells. It means they do not play roles in learning. Microglia, they are innate immune cells. They play important roles to keep the neural stem cell to be healthy and differentiate into new neurons. However, injury can induce microglia activation, and the microglia can release toxic chemicals which will injure the neural stem cells and even newborn neurons. My previous research demonstrated that injury can induce microglia activation. Just look at the soma of those microglia. They become much bigger and like baseball, and also have very short processes. It means they are activated. I also demonstrate activated microglia can express specific enzyme, which will produce toxic metabolites and injure neural stem cells and even newborn neurons. My students helped me evaluate the morphology of microglia cells. We found there's not much difference in the cell body. However, the length of the processes significantly decreased in TBI group. It means when the patients were 1 year old get trauma. However, 18 years later, their microglia are still activated. Our finding is published in Journal of Neurotrauma, like a conference abstract. I truly appreciate all our students' contribution. Currently, I have multiple research projects going on. All of them are clinically relevant, so my students can have hands-on research experience. Also, appreciate the collaboration among our faculty members, especially across the research field. My students are helping me with different aspects of the research, such as gene and protein expression, immunohistochemistry, cell tracing, and behavioral tests to evaluate efficacy of treatment. Last but not least, thank you for all your help and support. Thank you for your time and patience.